Wow, thank you so much, Cara, for that amazing introduction. Thank you to Dr. Owuba. Thank you so much for all the work that you do and to everyone at Action Against Hunger. There is absolutely no reason why in 2019 people should still be dying of malnutrition. And Charles, I agree with what you said, that we of course can and we must do better. Like Charles, my parents know the reality of hunger in a way that, thankfully, my own children likely never will. My mother was born and raised in Nigeria in the 1960s, a few years after the end of colonialism. My tribe, the Igbos, began fighting for independence in a war known as the Biafra War. The most devastating weapon the military used against my tribe was starvation. And that meant my mother, like millions of others, was forced to eat snakes, lizards, and crickets to survive. During the war, there was one rule that my mother lived by above all else when it came to hunger. Never, ever finish your food. You never, ever finished your food. Whatever you had for dinner, you always saved at least half until the next day, because you never knew when your next meal would come. So she never ate to be full. She only ever ate to postpone starvation, at least for another day. My mother, with her 9 brothers and sisters, lived that way for 2.5 years, hiding specks of snake meat under their beds, arguments breaking out if one person suspected another person of taking extra food from the pot. One of my uncles, Arthur, who was 8 at the time, died from a combination of hunger and health issues, along with 2 million other members of my tribe as well. It's easy to dismiss this kind of famine, Nigeria, 1960s, civil war, as something the world moved past in the 20th century. But this situation is still happening today, especially in places like Yemen and Syria. As I'm speaking here to you right now, 820 million people in the world do not have enough food to lead a healthy, active life, and nearly half of all deaths in children under the age of 5 is caused by poor nutrition. The problem isn't that we don't know that this is happening. The problem is that we do know, but we're not doing enough. How can we do more? During the Biafran War, global TV reporting meant that images of malnourished Nigerian children with massive bloated bellies and emaciated stick frames were broadcast all over the world. And after seeing the images over and over again, NGOs, charities, various groups, churches banded together to airlift food and medicine to millions, providing relief to my family and countless others. My mother says that if it wasn't for the entire world seeing these images, if it wasn't for those images forcing the world to act, I probably would not be standing here today. And that tells you just how much responsibility we have to share these stories. People cannot be moved to act if they have no idea what's going on. And at CNN, we have a moral responsibility to make sure that they do know. That is why we continue to highlight the plight of the world's poorest, even when viewers are more interested in the royal wedding or the Super Bowl. We still cover the war in Yemen, where at least 8.5 million children are on the brink of starvation. We still cover the economic mismanagement in Venezuela, which has led to mass food shortages. We still cover the droughts in Somalia and Zimbabwe, where crops are being wiped out. All of these crises are unique in their cause, but they each have one thing in common. The longer we wait, the more people will die. That is not an exaggeration. While my mother and her siblings were eating snakes and lizards during the Biafra War, and while some of them were suffering from hepatitis, dysentery, malnutrition, my grandfather left the house one day in search of food and medical supplies. 2 days after he left, his son, my uncle Arthur, was dead. His last words were, "Is Papa back?" Eight hours after my Uncle Arthur died, my grandfather finally returned home with food and medicine. Like my uncle, there are thousands of children who are just a few hours away from losing that fight against hunger. We can, everybody in this room, help them win that fight by working together and acting now. Thank you.